What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to rotate and save your video rotation using VLC Media Player on your PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Open up the VLC Media application and open the video which you want to rotate. In case you're unable to open the video using VLC, then navigate to Media and select Open File. From your File Explorer, you can select the video you wish to rotate. Next, navigate to Tools and select Effects and Filters. In the Adjustments and Effects window, make sure that you're in the Video Effects section and proceed to the Geometry tab. First, you have the option to enable Transform. This will allow you to rotate the video by 90, 180 or 270 degrees. You also have the option to flip the video. If you want to rotate the video by a specific degree, then make sure to enable the Rotate option below, which will allow you to choose a rotation to your liking. When saving this video file, it will be saved as the rotated version on your PC. You also have the option to automatically rotate all future videos which are opened with VLC. To do so, navigate to Tools and select Preferences. On the bottom left of this window, make sure that the Show Settings option is set to All. Next, navigate to Stream Output, Sound Stream, Transcode. Here, under Video Filter, enable the Rotate Video Filter and Video Transformation Filter options before saving your changes. Lastly, close this window and in the Media tab, click on Convert/Save. On this window, make sure to add the video you rotated to this list before clicking on Convert/Save again. In the Convert window, make sure that Convert is selected in your settings and proceed to change the output format if you want. Choose a destination folder on your PC where you wish to save your newly rotated video. It might take a minute or two to save the rotated version of your video, depending on the size and resolution of your file. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.